Today I'm going to explain the prologue and chapter 1 of Punishing Grey Raven. This video contains spoilers. The story of the game begins in the city of 015. Lucia, the leader of the Grey Raven team, is seen on the ground next to a pile of infected mechs known as the Corrupted, caused by the Punishing Virus. Although constructs like herself are technically mechanoids, having a human-like consciousness has caused her to become too fatigued to fight. In pain and too exhausted to even lift a finger, she requests her pain receptors to be disabled from her commandant to continue fighting until help arrives. The commandant reluctantly agrees and uses the Inver device, which connects the minds of constructs to the consciousness of humans, to manipulate her ability to no longer feel pain. After a successful reboot of her system, Lucia continues to defend herself and the commandant from the Corrupted that's swarming around them. During their unending battle against the Corrupted, they hear a familiar voice warning them to take cover. Within seconds, the high-density energy beam is blasted across the battlefield, carving a path for escape. With a new passageway created by the energy beam, Lucia and the commandant fights their way through the remaining Corrupted to reach the origination of the energy beam. Upon their arrival, they meet up with Liv and Lee, the rest of the Grey Raven team. The energy beam was created by Liv, but now that her weapon core has melted, her battle capabilities were no longer functioning. To continue their mission of clearing out City 015 from the Corrupted, they decide to head towards a signal emitter created by a nearby squad to resupply. In the process, they come across a church to get to their meeting point. Inside the church, the group is confronted by a mysterious figure known as Alpha. Although Alpha looked to be an ally due to her appearance resembling that of a construct, they quickly realize that Alpha was exhibiting a high level of Punishing Virus and assumes her to have become one of the Corrupted. During their confrontation, Lucia's stability of her mind begins to drop due to an unknown reason, causing her visual signals and her thoughts to become hazy. With Liv unable to battle and Lee's attack not affecting Alpha at all, Lucia loses her fight and breaks her arm in the process. The commandant shoots at Alpha and attempts to distract her. She becomes amused and disgusted that Lucia is still working with humans. After a brief conversation, Alpha becomes dumbfounded at Lucia's resolve and decides to leave after questioning if their resolve can be retained after learning about the truth. After a quick glance towards the commandant, Alpha leaves the scene. With Alpha now gone, Liv temporarily fixes Lucia's arm and the team continues their way towards the meeting point. Now, sometime before this event took place, a certain painting robot named Anthony comes across a travel note written by a certain machine. After reading this note, Anthony becomes enlightened and gains a certain level of consciousness. It begins to wish for freedom, happiness, and individuality, calling the writer of this note as Sage Machina. Due to Anthony's past of being manipulated by humans, it decides to go on a journey to free other robots from the enslavement by the Punishing Virus and humans. Anthony begins to evangelize the will of the Sage Machina by encoding the messages into his graffitis. Upon seeing these imageries, the other Corrupted robots also become enlightened and less hostile. They begin to group together and form a type of organization for the sake of freedom left behind by the Sage Machina. Several construct squads in the City 015 begins to freak out and attempts to stop the gathering of the Corrupted by destroying the graffitis. Taking this as a sign of resistance towards their will of freedom, Anthony begins to kill off the constructs with the help of his followers. After the incident with Alpha, when the Grey Raven team finally arrived at the signal emitter to meet with the supply squad, they were met with an atrocious sight. Numerous constructs remains being scavenged by the Corrupted. Seeing this occurring, the Grey Raven team clears the area of the remaining Corrupted, and in process, Lucia breaks her arm yet again. In a nearby bridge, they find a survivor among the supply squad. He explains that his squad was attacked by a large gathering of Corrupted and had to retreat to this location. Before leaving, the survivor thanks the team for saving him and gives Lucia a replacement arm along with the coordinates of spare parts for Liv's levy gun. With a new arm, Lucia's pain receptors are turned back online to lessen the potential corruption of her mind. The team then heads towards the coordinates to fix Liv's weapon systems. When they reached their destination, they saw more construct remains blown into pieces with paint all over their bodies. Seeing the method used to kill the constructs, the team becomes upset, as Lee stating that this method was horrid. This statement triggers and angers the dark, ominous figure hiding in the shadows. After gathering the parts to fix Liv's weapon system, Liv connects into the dead squad member's mind to understand what had happened here. As Liv battles through the corruption inside the minds of the constructs, the other members defend their physical body on the outside. They learn that a squad was sent here to get rid of the corrupted, just like the Grey Raven team. However, this squad saw the corrupted gathering and forming an organization due to a strange graffiti. Taking this action as a sign of free will, the squad members hurriedly try to return back to HQ. In the process, one of the members carelessly erases the graffiti and are met with the mysterious figure and its follower. After Lucia and the team learned about the truth, the mysterious figure hiding in the shadow shows itself and begins to attack the squad. But instead of fighting, it sprays paint all over Lee's jacket out of spite for calling its work horrible. Lee gets extremely upset over his jacket and begins chasing after the painting robot. The robot gets spooked by the Grey Raven team and escapes. After this encounter, the team learns that this corrupted was called Nozzle, a painting robot that was created to do biddings of humans. Fortunately for the team, even after Nozzle escapes, one canister on Nozzle was cracked and left behind paint for them to use to track it down. After dealing with several corrupted along the way, they reached the end of the trail, only to find that the trail abruptly ends and Nozzle was nowhere to be found. After escaping the Grey Raven team, Nozzle continues to search for more places to paint his graffitis, laughing off his prank towards Lee in the process. In its search for new locations to paint, it comes across a scene of battle against constructs and a creepy figure resembling an Iron Maiden. As a bystander, Nozzle watches the battle as constructs sprint past it, fleeing in fear. Seeing this unfold, the Iron Maiden questions why it's not stopping the constructs from escaping. Nozzle answers that if they don't mess with this art, it doesn't care. With pity and disappointment, the Iron Maiden launches an attack to end Nozzle. Being outclassed and overpowered by the Ascendant, Nozzle fights to its death, only to be saved by its followers. With the followers' sacrifice, Nozzle flees the scene. After escaping the grasp of the Iron Maiden, Nozzle continues to draw graffitis with the small amount of energy that it had left. After losing track of Nozzle, the Grey Raven team was left in a daze. Coincidentally, an organizer from HQ named Celica calls them to check on their status. Lucia asks for help to track down Nozzle, and with Celica's assistance, they were notified of Nozzle's current location. To reach Nozzle, they had to cut through the shopping arcade. At the shopping arcade, Lucia becomes distracted and the team decides to take a small break. Lucia and Liv find a couple plushie dolls to take along with them. After leaving the shopping arcade, they finally arrive to confront Nozzle once again. To stop it from creating more graffitis, along with a small sense of grudge for Lee's jacket, the team launches a full assault towards Nozzle and its followers. For the sake of robots' freedom and to escape the grasp of humans and Ascendants, Nozzle fights against the Grey Raven team. But after all of Nozzle's followers were destroyed, it becomes infuriated and the punishing virus's activity begins to overtake Nozzle. This causes it to take its final stance and ultimately losing to the Grey Raven team. Before losing consciousness, Nozzle explains that this will not change the will of Sage Machina, and the pursuit of freedom for robots will continue. Upon hearing this and seeing the aftermath, Liv starts to feel sad for unknown reasons, to which Lucia responds, it was just a part of the mission and she shouldn't feel so sad. With Nozzle defeated, the team tries to extract its memories to get more information about Ascendants that it mentioned during their battle when they received another call from Celica. Under the direct orders of Hassan, the leader of humanity, the Grey Raven team was to temporarily suspend their current mission in City 015 to clear out the corrupted. They were told to return to Babylonia, where their HQ is located, immediately due to another problem occurring in this city. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to smash like and subscribe for more content on this channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.